Hello, welcome to this film review for the film Harriet, which came out last year in 2019. And it's a really good film, and it's a biographical film about someone called Harriet Tubman, who I'm ashamed to say I've never heard of before, but she's quite an important person in history. She was a black woman who was a slave before the Civil War, and she escaped to freedom, then came back and rescued a bunch more slaves, and then the Civil War happened, and basically the film shows her life. And I don't know how I've never heard of her before, because I've heard of other historical figures in America, like Martin Luther King and Malcolm X and people like that, and Rosa Parks, obviously. But I've never heard of Harriet Tubman, and I'm not sure how that can be, because, like, she did a lot of really good things. So I'm glad I watched this film to actually learn a bit about her. Cynthia Erivo plays Harriet, and she does a really good job at portraying the character. It is a really well done role, and you can see a lot of emotion in her role and the way that she is, and, you know, when she's going through some bad times, you can see that, and when she's mad, you can see that, and angry, and when she's trying to help these people, and, you know, you can see all these things. She's very good at portraying these sort of emotions through her face and her actions and her language. It was really well done. This film does go a long way to make you understand and see the suffering they went through. You don't see things that are too violent or anything, but you see, like, the aftermath of things. You see, like, people's scars on their body where they've obviously been whipped in the past. And she gives a speech at one point talking about how they're treated. And, you know, it's really quite hard-hitting and powerful stuff. And although it's an important film, it's an educational film, it's also an entertaining film. Because they could have just made this film very lecherous about how shitty everything was in the past. And they chose not to do that. They tried to, obviously, they want people to engage with the film, so it has to be entertaining as well. And I think they got the balance right. Because I did actually find on YouTube after watching the film, there is a whole documentary about her life, which is, you know, very just talking about it, and it's not very entertaining. I suppose if you're into history, then it might be. But so they've got the balance right there when they made the film to say this isn't a film. Because obviously, if you watch a film, you want to enjoy it. You watch films to enjoy yourself. You don't watch a film to become miserable. Well, I don't know, maybe some people do. So it is an enjoyable film, but it's also an educational film at the same time, and they got the balance right there, I feel. They could have easily messed up, and I feel that they did a good job. I'm just having a quick look at the actors and actresses, and there isn't really any name that springs out at me. Filmmakers didn't rely on a big name to sell the film. They just wanted to have the raw talent of people that some people may not necessarily know or heard of before. The lead role at Cynthia, I'm just having a quick look on her IMDb. She's done a few things that people might know her from. She's been in a few TV shows. But yeah, I mean, I can see good things for her in the future. I really can. If she decides to stick with the acting, I think she'll be a name to watch. I mean, looking at the IMDb, the first acting role was only 5 years ago, a TV show called Chewing Gum, and she's in one episode, and she's done a few things since then. But yeah, I think, you know, if she carries on acting the way she did, you know, she could be a real big name in the not too distant future, because she did a really good job and really portrayed the character of Harriet well. So yeah, I enjoyed it. I think it's a good watch. When I started watching this, I didn't actually know it was biographical. As you know, with many of the films I watch, I go into them almost completely blind, know nothing about them. And it got to about halfway through and I suddenly started thinking, I think this might be based on real events and not just fiction. And because I was getting worried for her at some points, because I was thinking, you're going to get killed. You're gonna get captured. You're gonna get tortured. It's all horrible, but and she didn't, and I don't know what it was about it that made me think, like, this might be real. And I looked her up, and yeah, she is real. It's based on her life. One criticism I do have about the film, it's a minor criticism, but they're trying to put a large amount of Harriet's life into the 2-hour film. So it goes from the time she escapes to the end of the Civil War, so it's quite a few years in that gap. And to condense it all down to 2 hours, they have to cut out large chunks of time. So like, and when she escapes and she goes 100 miles up to Philadelphia, she gets there quite quickly, and then suddenly she's back again. She does most of this on foot, and she gets a couple of rides here and there, but it's going to take quite a while to do that. And she does this trip quite a few times, and they kind of skip through it a bit. And there are a few other moments when I was thinking, okay, they've really have jumped forwards in time. When she goes back and finds her husband, who's remarried because he thought she had died, so obviously quite a bit of time had passed. And I did find the way it jumped, it was a little bit jarring. I know films do this, they jump forwards in time quite a bit sometimes. Some films make it kind of obvious that time has passed in some way. Sometimes they might put like a caption at the bottom showing the year. Like they did that at the start of the film, they showed what year it was. But then after that, they kind of, it just moved steadily onwards with quite large jumps in places. But it's understandable because they're trying to show this portion of her life, and they can only do it in a 2-hour film. But there were a couple of times where I found where they've jumped quite a long distance into the future. Then at the end, it really starts accelerating as the Civil War gets going. It really starts accelerating into the future. At one point, it does actually say 2 years later, or 2 years into the Civil War. So it, and I'm thinking, well, they put a year at the very beginning of the film showing when it is, and then they did this bit right at the end showing that time has progressed. So they could have done it in the middle, and it wouldn't have broken any of the rules of the film, since they do have that in the film. But that's a minor criticism. But other than that, yeah, it's a good film. Go watch it. All right, bye.